Now see in the last video, from that video we are learning the SL1 mechanism, and into that we learn the two points into that. That is the reaction and about the rate of the reaction. Now see in the third point, that is the silent features of this mechanism. Now here, this is the first step I write here in the reaction. In the steps two, the first reaction is remaining. Now this is the first reaction, the first one we learn, that is the rate determining step. Now this is the first step, and this step do not determining the rate. In this step, immediately the new nucleophile attacks on this carbocation, and there is formation of tertiary butyl alcohol. Now this OH minus attack on this, and there is formation of this tertiary butyl alcohol. OH get attached here. Do you understand that? Now see here. Now what is in the third point? Now there are the silent features of SN1 mechanism. In that silent feature, you must write down in the first point that it is the two-step mechanism. Because in the first step, there is the rate determining step, there is the hydrolysis to form carbocation and the halide ion. In the second step, this is second step, into that the new nucleophile attack on this carbocation, and there is formation of tertiary butyl alcohol. So it is the two-step mechanism. Now next point is here a heterolysis of the CX bond. Heterolytic fission is observed there in the slow step, and which is the reversible first step. That slow step is reversible because we show the both side arrows into that to form the planar carbocation intermediate. In the first step, what happened? There is the formation of planar carbocation, planar cation. This is the, in the first step, this is formed. Okay. Now in second step, the attack of the nucleophile, this is the second step. There is the attack of this new nucleophile on that carbocation, which is intermediate, is the first second step. And into that second step, to form the product. Product is tertiary butyl alcohol. Now this is the second step. Now, what is in the next step? When SN2 mechanism is carried out, what happened? At that chiral carbon, now this is also the chiral carbon, because, no, this is not in tertiary butyl, this is not, because the three methyl groups are similar. But if this mechanism is carried out into the chiral carbon, then what happened? The optically active substrate, if there, then there is the formation of racemic mixture. Racemic mixture means 50% molecules rotate the plane of plane polarized light to the right hand side or clockwise direction, and 50% molecule rotate the plane of plane polarized light to the anti-clockwise or left hand side. We know that. What is racemic mixture? Dextrorotatory and leorotatory are 50-50%. Why there are dextrorotatory and leorotatory, both products are 50-50%? Because there is no backside attack now. Now this OH minus can attack from this side or from this side, both sides. So 50% molecules having the inversion of configuration, and 50% molecules having the retention. Inversion means at just umbrella open outside in the rainy season. If there is the very fast wind, umbrella get open in this way. Such type of configuration, opposite configuration, 50% molecule, and retention means same configuration of that of the 50% molecule of the tertiary butyl alcohol. So due to that, there is the racemic mixture is formed. So this reaction or this mechanism indicates that the SN1 mechanism proceeds with the racemization. Racemization means there is formation of racemic mixture. We will draw that structure, how the 50% molecule having the retention of configuration means same configuration, and how the 50% molecule have the inversion of configuration, and due to that there is the formation of racemic mixture. So it is followed the racemization. Now both the enantiomers product form in equal amount, and due to the planar carbocation, this is one, because this carbon is planar, so the OH minus ion attack from both sides. If they attack from the same side, there is the retention of configuration. But if it attacks on the opposite side, then there is the inversion of configuration. So both enantiomers of product form in an equal amount due to the planar carbocation, and nucleophiles can attack from either side of that carbocation to form both enantiomer, that is 50% immersion and 50% retention of the molecules. We will see that structure into the next video. Thank you.